Dan.
In the 100 tapings I've been to Overheard, you're one of the most entertaining and unique. And since you're a teacher, you need to read Drama High, which is about probably the best high school drama teacher ever. Just came out last year. Highly recommended.
Drama High?
Yes.
Okay.
My question is, how did you transition from the rep theater to Injustice for All?
Very good question. I did, I was in Milwaukee at the Milwaukee Repertory Theater, and I just said, I'm 35 years old, and if I don't go to New York now, out of Repertory and try Broadway, it was my dream. Broadway, stepping on a Broadway stage, I went to New York, and I met Arthur Penn, and I got three lines in a play called Sly Fox, written by Larry Gelbart, directed by Arthur Penn. People told me not to take it, because I had to be an understudy and you only have three lines. And I later took over the lead role.
Wow.
And with George, I went out to LA, and Valerie Curtin and Barry Levinson saw me on stage and they went,
that's the guy.
That's the guy. And it was a trip. The only thing is I worried myself sick during the all of Injustice for All, to the point that I can't watch it anymore. Because,
really?
Yeah, because it was so easy, which we were talking about, right. How easy it is.
Yeah.
Because it can't be this easy, and I can't be getting this much money to do what is easy.
Right.
And so I tried to make it hard by worrying.
You talk yourself into it.
Now, the audience doesn't see it, but everyone's going like this.
They know.
Because that's the ball game, you see? And that's what almost stopped me from... Well, it actually did. I remember once doing Hill Street Blues, and I remember I used to run 10 miles a day, and I did my scene, and I was running, and I was going over the lines that I had just filmed, and I stopped, and I went, something is very, very wrong here. And what I was saying, basically, was, how good can this be? I'm in it. See, my father taught me, my father taught me a bad lesson, and it was, don't celebrate, they'll take it away from you. That was a story that he had. And that's very, very inimical to our family.
Honestly, it's a pretty good lesson. Don't get too comfortable with any success because it can go away in a minute.
Well, that's right. Not what he's saying. He's saying don't celebrate, and that's wrong. They'll take it away from you is wrong. But if you understand his history and the history of Jews, I mean, they will take it away from you. I mean, they will. You got to keep a low profile. So his whole thing was which is bad. So I went, oh my God, I'm out. I'm walking around with Al Pacino.
I'm celebrating.
I mean, I'm about to burst into stardom. And it all went haywire for me. It was like
where along that continuum then do you become comfortable?
I'm not.
Still. You'll let me know.
No, I work on it. That's why I teach. Yeah. That's why I know I seem very confident, but I have to work on this. I mean, I am confident and I do have techniques, but I'm human. And to shake is very, very human. And I tried to get out of doing the edu thing yesterday. They went, last year was Bill Gates. And I went, I'm out.
I can't do it. No pressure.
Bill Gates.
No pressure.
A, Bill Gates to Jeffrey Tambor. That's A to B. And they went, no. And they were great. They were on their feet. They were wonderful.
Well, they loved
but,
you. Come on.
But no, I said they were on their feet. Standing ovation.
But not, yeah, that's fantastic. That's
you remind me so much of my mother. You could be my mother. You are actually channeling. You are now channeling my mother.
I'm telling you, you've never made me so happy as you just did.
Your
Sir.
Question.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey. Hey, Jeff. Hey, Jeff.
It's Austin. Hey, babe.
Hey,
go
Jeff.
Ahead. Hey, Jeff.
Hey, Jeff. No one calls me Jeff. My wife and I think someone else.
And him.
I was wondering what to call you, but then you refer to yourself as Jeff in your story, so I was like, it's okay to call him Jeff.
No, Clef.
No, Clef. Hey, Clef.
Go ahead.
I think one of the first things you learn in acting is that vulnerability is at the core of it, and you have to be completely vulnerable by your acting partner. So then how do you respond to someone who's maybe less than willing to be vulnerable around you when you're in a scene or in a performance?
You play with what you got. How would you be on a date if you were with a person who was less vulnerable? You play that. I didn't know that at first. I used to not, well, I had trouble with that whole thing. I used to come almost with a spiritual and psychological condom around me. I would, whatever you do, I don't want to, my performance was here, I wouldn't share and everything like that. You just take it in. The same as if you know, I mean, I can tell certain things about you. I'm playing who you are right now. And the whole, your personality and my personality, you just play, it's not a problem. Are you talking about talent or are you talking about vulnerability?
People
are not, there are degrees of vulnerability in people. Sometimes you walk up to people and you go, I know that person. And other people you go, I don't know that person. I got to find out a little more about them. Does that seem like a good answer?
Seems like one.
Just say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Should you just say seems like one? That's so funny. That's passive aggressive.
He kind of got, I didn't mean that.
He kind of did.
But we
that.
Are That's playing right. the scene right now.
Yeah.
Right. Because you're not vulnerable at all and you need to work on it.
Can I ask one other quick thing?
Oh, Jesus. Yeah.
You don't come off nearly as sleazy as you do in a lot of things that I see you in.
Yes.
Wow.
Thank you so much for gabbing this guy come up, by the way.
Why do you gravitate towards
Is your name Mike by any chance?
He's getting back at you, that's it.
Why do you gravitate towards those?
You know, on my IMBD or whatever that, what is that other thing?
IMDB. IMDB?
My mother, I got it. That's right. It's IMDB.
I'm going to leave it out there for you.
Don't embarrass me. It's IMDB, Jeffrey. And another thing, they say I play that. But a lot of roles I play there's a stereotype in there used to be a guy named Fred Clark. Do you remember who that was?
Fred.
And the boss on the Mary Tyler Moore Show. There is the bald-headed guy with glasses who's officious and the, you know, there is that sort of thing. But I like playing, to answer your question, I love eccentric people. I love, Shakespeare had a group of players, and there was one player who was always called the eccentric. And I think had I been alive in that time, I would have been the eccentric. I love the edge. I love chaos. I love to cause trouble. I love it.
George Bluth and Hank Kingsley are not necessarily cut from the same.
Well, Hank Kingsley is very vulnerable.
Yeah.
I mean, I made him when, on just a moment when Gary, invited him to the, because someone fell out to the poker game, I made Hank cry. In other words, that's how he felt like.
Right.
George is, you know, I must say, and Mitch is more responsible. Mitch is very present with George. And I think I'm more present with Oscar. Does that make any sense, what
just
said?
Sure.
What else?
That's it. Thank you.
Sit down.
He got to. Sit down.
Just sit down.
Sit down, Mike. We have time for one or two more if anybody wants to jump up and ask a question
Here we go.
To our guest. Here we go.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. By the time he gets there,
we'll
be out of time. That's
don't
okay.
Walk slower. Hi.
Yes, hi.
My name is Michael.
Best line of the day.
Hi, Mike. Yeah.
Do you have time to do any L.A. Theater while you're out there? I know when I lived in Topanga, that Will Gear Theater was just great.
You know, I lived in Topanga.
I think I saw you at the post office there once.
Oh.
Not on the wall, but in the post
office. You're not about to just say something that's going to embarrass the heck out of me, like you were stealing something from a post office box. Or,
No.
I love Topanga. Yeah. You know, they sold that Will Gear, not the Will Gear Theatricum Botanicum, but that other place, anyway, they've sold that and made that into a house. I did, at the Skylight Theater, I directed Lanford Wilson's Burn This.
Wow.
And I loved it. I love directing, but I like teaching more. I'm about a BB plus. There are some really, 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 really great. Why I teach is that I have had actors in my class that are Mozarts to acting that have not gone on for some reason. And I always, what do you do for a living?
I'm a writer.
I'm a writer now. I'm writing my book.
What is the book?
I don't think that's any of your business.
I guess
not. No, my book is a memoir cum, it's this.
It's literally
this. It is the toughest thing I've ever had to do because you have to, I thought you had to be inspired to sit down. You have to sit down to be inspired. Do you get that? You have to assume that position. It's really, really one of the most awesome things I've ever had to do. Are you a good writer?
I'm an out-of-print novelist, is what I am.
Well, that's not has nothing to do with being good or bad.
Yeah.
And that's I'm so glad you said that, because I just met somebody on the plane who had stopped writing, and we had this long conversation. I am so curious about life. I have this theory that we have these stories that keep us. Certainly one of my stories is, that's a story. And that has kept me. Literally, when every time I've gone out and about to break through, it has drawn me back.
Yep.
It's like a rubber band, you know? And I'm so curious about the stories that we fabricate to make us more comfortable, if that makes any sense.
It does. Thank you.
You're welcome. Any more? Any question? Just shout it out. Do it.
I think that's it.
We have done it? Come on. What?
Isn't your middle name Michael?
Yes. Perfect to end.
It's a perfect place to end, right?
Perfect. I am my own Michael.
You are Michael. Exactly.
Oh, my God.
It's like the horror movie where the phone calls from in the house.
Oh, my God.
Right? That's it.
This is right. My book is, oh, my God, I've become Michael.
I'm Michael.
Thank you so
much. Thank you so much.
You got to
it.
Well,
okay, yeah.
Question. Yeah.
So stepping on a Broadway stage for you was kind of like a thing you had to do as the next great achievement. What is the next great achievement?
What is next?
I think I'm in it.
This is it today.
Yeah. I think whatever this is, and I don't, what's your name? Mike.
Daniel.
Mike.
I think Mike. Mike Daniel. I think the next step for me is in transition right now. It's whatever this is, and I don't understand it. It's why I was in Nebraska, 2 hours out of Rapid City, in snow up to here, talking to elementary school teachers who were shaking and quaking, saying, Mr. Tambor, how do we teach? We're about to get $22,000, and how do we do that? And what tips do you have? And I don't know why I'm there, but I love it.
Yep.
It's very meaningful to me. It is the most personal. It's got me into London, Ontario. I'm going to New Orleans next week. I don't understand it, but I love it.
But this is it.
Yeah.
They're telling me we're out of time. Let's give them a big hand, Jeffrey Tambor, for being here. Thank you so much.